Good Wednesday afternoon, Grace Trenton folks. Pastor Hutch here, reaching out to you for our Wednesday Word of the Week. So on Sunday, we celebrated our Super Bowl. Easter Sunday, we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus and His victory over sin and death forever. But Easter is not just one day where we celebrate and then move on to normal, ordinary life. Easter is an entire season in the church calendar. The season of Easter begins Easter Sunday and moves for 50 days leading up to the Pentecost Sunday. But it's an entire season for us to meditate on the significance of resurrection, to anticipate our own redemption and renewal, and to serve and minister to our community and our neighbors as we demonstrate this hope of future resurrection. So we're not moving on from Easter. It's not just a day and then we go on. This is an entire season to celebrate and to remember and work out the implications of Easter. Now, on Sunday, we looked at our passage in Romans 8 and how Paul talked about this groaning that we experience in our own life, even in our own bodies, in our struggle with sin and temptation as we anticipate that redemption, that resurrection, but also that even creation itself is groaning, even in the pains of childbirth, as he described it, in its bondage to decay. Creation itself is longing for redemption. Now, little did we know that that very night, Sunday night, we were going to very tangibly experience a very vivid reminder of that groaning as a tornado moved through our community in almost the same path that a tornado took in the super outbreak of 2011. And many people in our community sustained significant damage. Some folks in our own congregation sustained damage. And for the past 2 days, we've been able to be out with some crews from our church, helping people to clean up and put things back together. Here's what we're going to do going forward. Tomorrow and Friday, one of our deacons, James Odd, is going to be working through those hit communities and making an assessment of different needs that are there, and he's going to report back to us. And in the coming weeks, we're going to assess ways that we as a church can enter in and help. Here's what we want to ask you to do. We want you to reach out and let us know if you have sustained damage, or if you know a family or friends here in Dade County that have sustained damage, and get back to us and let us know. But then also, we want to encourage you to be really intentional with your neighbors. Check in on your neighbors. Reach out to them. Pick up the phone. Knock on a door. But check on your neighbors and see, have they sustained damage? How are they doing in this season? Do they have needs that are arising? And then reach back out and let us know. And we're going to be putting together a plan for ways that we can come alongside certain families and people who are in need in our community. And in this way, we get to demonstrate future resurrection and the hope of Jesus. So reach out to us. Check in on your neighbors, let us know, and let's together embody resurrection. Okay, good to be with you. We'll talk soon.